Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on the show, if you're looking for the latest in data visualization and business analytics, today we're going to take a comprehensive look at Power BI. We'll cover BI basics, including recent updates with Power BI desktop app, and we'll take a tour of the brand new capabilities, including web-based editing for your Power BI reports, new options to create your own custom visualizations, and capabilities to automatically detect patterns in your data. So welcome back to the show, Michael.
Thanks, Jeremy. Tell us
what's new with Power BI.
Well, we've actually, last time we did a show, we were just entering into preview. And it's been about 10 months since then. We've hit general availability. We've added hundreds of new features to the product.
OK, so why don't you give us a look at all the things that you can do?
All right, so a couple things. One, this is the same dashboard that I showed last show, but it looks a lot better. We've got more visualizations. We've got new charting engine. What I can do is I can drill into these live tiles, and it takes me to underline reports that show me additional detail that I can then explore.
Okay.
I can navigate this report, I can slice my data, I can get different views of the data. I can also edit this report. Now, the editing is new since the last time we actually did a show. You can see here you've got these two new panels that come out. You can see that you can change all your different visualizations. You see your models here. I'm going to actually create a visualization, so I'm going to delete this one. And then we're going to pull some information over. So I'm going to take a look at, this is a model that's on business travel, or it's on traveling expenses across my business, and we're going to take a look at business travel costs. And then maybe we want to take a look at that by the actual country where the planes are, people are departing from. And then filter that down. You can see here you can filter it by a number of different things. I'm going to filter it down for just European travel, right?
Mm-hmm.
So here we'll end up getting a nice little view of our European travel across the company, across all the different countries in Europe. And you can see that you can very easily sort of change the visualization. So here you can see we've changed that to a pie chart. You can change it to a tree map. You can see that the cross filters all work and that type of thing. One of the other great things that we've introduced is we've actually open sourced our data visualization framework.
Okay.
So now you can go to GitHub and you can download the samples and the framework and you can build your own visualizations. And our community are creating some great new visualizations.
And do you have some of these running here? One thing I want to take a step back with is that's actually in the browser. All of what you're showing here, all of the visualization types, that's running in a browser. So you don't have any apps to install in this case.
No, it's a great point. Yeah, this is all browser-based editing. So I can actually really customize these reports and the dashboards all through the browser.
That's terrific. So let's see a customized report or customized visualization. Sorry.
Sure, yeah. So I've got a couple here from the community. You can see a list. We've got heat maps. There's breakdown trees, bubble charts. All kinds of fancy stuff that they've gone and created, which are really interesting, and I encourage everybody to go take a look. There's a radar chart that I like, so I'm going to import that radar chart. And you can see it appears as one of the visualization types in Power BI. And then when I click it, you can see that the radar chart comes up, and then it interacts with the rest of the report as well. So those visualizations act just like any other visualizations in Power BI. Now, if I go back, I want to show you something else as well. So one of the great things that we've built into the dashboards are natural language query. And
okay.
The way that this works is I can type any questions I have in my data. So say, show me the total number of trips for internal versus external travel versus maybe trade show travel versus recruiting purposes as examples. And every time I type, what's happening is that the system is understanding the semantics of what I'm typing and then bringing back the data from the underlying data source and showing it in the visualization.
And the great thing is I actually don't have to be a DBA and have to know SQL queries or DAX querying language to be able to get these visualizations, right?
No, that's right. So it essentially allows a more sort of a casual user of data to be able to actually get some really interesting insights out of their out of their data. And then once I've got this sort of little visualization that I want to track, I can also sort of customize this if I like, change the colors and all that great stuff. Mm-hmm. And then once it's just right, I can pin it back to my dashboard and I can continue to monitor that, track that data alongside all of the other different visualizations that are in my report. So you can see, you can move it around and customize it just the way you want it.
So great stuff. And I know we've done a lot of work in terms of being able to collaborate better inside of Power BI too, right?
That's right. That's another one of our great new features, is support for Office 365 groups. So I can go in here and I can actually create a group in Power BI. Mm-hmm. And what that allows me to do is define who's in my team, work team, whatever it happens to be. And it's just the members of that team that will have access to the dashboards and the reports.
Right.
They'll have edit rights, they can change them, they can collaborate around the data. The other great thing is that because we're leveraging the Office 365 groups feature, it allows me to navigate to all the other workloads in Office 365.
Right, like the calendar, your files, all these things that you're going to need in terms of getting group teamwork done are right there from Power BI.
That's right.
So what else do you have to show us? Because I know you've done some work in terms of a new locally installed app to help build some of these reports.
That's right. We now have a new a free Power BI desktop tool. And the desktop tool is a tool that we've created to allow business analysts to work with their data.
Now hold on, how does this differ from Excel?
Well, it's actually very similar to Excel. So the work that we've done around being able to connect to your data, being able to transform that data, model that data, that work, that experience is consistent between Excel and the Power BI tool. So essentially what I do as a business analyst is learn how to do this one time and then I can choose which tool I want to use. Excel allows you to build those analytical spreadsheets, and this is a tool for really building those interactive reports. It's a free form canvas with drag and drop and data exploration.
Got it. Well, let's see what this can do.
Well, here you can see inside the tool, if we take a look at all the data that we can connect through to, we've got a broad range of different data sources. So we've got flat files, we've got databases, we've got services that live up on Azure. So if I think about streaming data into the product, or data that might sit in a big data source like HD Insight, we can connect through to that. We can connect through to Hadoop, to Spark, to data that might be in a number of different SaaS applications. All of these content connectors are all available to me so that I can connect to that data as a starting place.
Right.
Then once I've connected to that data, I can come in, I can model it up. Here we see a bunch of different connections between various different tables. I can add calculations on top of that data, so I can create my custom calcs and all that good stuff. And then is when, you know, once I've done all that data prep, I can build out my interactive reports. Mm-hmm. And it's a drag and drop canvas where I can create these different visualizations, same type of look and feel as we saw on the web, so it's very consistent to that. And then these are very interactive. So you can see that all the different visualizations are interconnected and will cross-filter. And once that's just the way I want it, I can actually publish that right into the Power BI service. And then if we go to the service, we can see that we see that same report here in the browser with all the interactivity that I just showed you. And then if I want, as we saw before, I can continue to edit this in the browser, those same that same experience shows up.
And all the sharing is very consistent with what you do in SharePoint to be able to let other people in your group or in your team see it.
That's right, yes. So it's a great way to share reports across the team.
But I know you've got more to show us, so why don't you tell us about some of the new stuff in addition to what you've already shown us.
Yeah, a couple other things. So last time we were here, we talked about one of the ways to get data into the Power BI service is also through these prepackaged content packs that we've created.
Right.
So the content packs are great. We've got a long, you know, we've extended the list. I think last time we were on the show, we had five or six. Now we're up to 29. We release one of these every single week. And a content pack is a pre-packaged set of dashboards and reports for a particular SaaS-based service. So all I have to do is log into that service, and my dashboards and reports get pre-populated with data.
But even beyond this, now we can actually create these for our own company, our own organization, right?
That's right. So inside your organization, you can create organizationally specific content packs.
Okay.
So this means that somebody's gone and packaged up a set of models and reports and dashboards all together, and then I, as an end user, all I have to do is come into this library. I can see all the different content packs across Microsoft that people have published out, and then click on that content pack and then connect.
That was really catching my eye earlier, the 520 bridge, super important for people that work in Redmond.
That's right. So the 520 bridge is the bridge that all the satellites cross over to get to work every morning. It's always congested. But this is a little dashboard that's being created inside Microsoft that actually shows you the volume of traffic during the time of day. So you can
see
that.
Hold on, that just updated there.
It's live. It's actually streaming data from the sensors on the bridge and the cameras from the toll bridge. So you see a lot of different information is captured. You actually see the colors of the cars and how many different cars are of particular color. You can see white is a very popular color for cars here in Seattle, apparently. You can see the number of cars that traveled over the bridge today, 48,000.
It always feels like it's a bit more than that.
It always feels like a lot more. So that's absolutely true. And there's one other thing I want to show you.
Okay.
So along the theme of making it easier to do more with your data, right? So it's easier for us to connect to data with those content packs. It's easier for us to interact with the data through the natural language query.
Mm-hmm.
We've also automated sort of the product to be able to discover trends and seasonality in your data and present that out to you.
Right.
So you can now actually get insights automatically presented for a data set. We've got a data set here. It's Hawaii data, Hawaii travel data. So essentially when you're flying into Hawaii, you fill out that little card of the intent of your trip and why you're there and all that good stuff. So we've got that data, and we can go and we can view insights that the product has automatically generated on that data.
Okay.
So a couple things. Where do you think people actually fly to Hawaii from the most?
Probably a lot from the United States.
That's right. So the West Coast is where they go the most to Hawaii.
And of course, every time I'm there, I see a lot of Japanese tourists.
Japanese is third on the list.
Okay.
Beat out my home country, Canada, by a small margin. And then the other interesting insights it's discovered, particularly around the Japanese tourists, one is that the actual per person spend per trip is coming down per Japanese tourists, which is interesting. But the number of days that they spend is actually longer. So the number of days in their trip is longer. So they're staying more days.
So that's a lot of new great capabilities. Where do I get started with Power BI?
Yeah, if you go to powerbi.com, you can get started for free. So you just enter your work address and we'll provision a free version of Power BI for you.
And in terms of how to get Power BI, what do I need to do there?
To get Power BI, we now have Power BI available standalone and is part of the Office 365 E5 offering, which is now available.
And of course, you can learn more. We've done a lot of great content on Power BI on Microsoft and Office Mechanics. If you go back to the shows, you can check out Lotus F1 Team's implementation of Power BI, as well as how we predicted El Clasico's match when we were in Barcelona. But we've also had a few shows with you, Michael.
Yeah, well, that's nice. Thanks.
So that's about all the time we have for today's show. Of course, you can stay up to date with the latest on Microsoft Mechanics Wednesdays or as news breaks. Thank you all for watching, and goodbye for now.